sin and death no longer have power over. Finally, with the long season of Pentecost, we celebrate Christ's gift to us of the Holy Spirit, and we follow the early church out into the world in God's great mission. Now, on this final Sunday of the church year, we look back and we look forward as we declare the ultimate truth that the one true authority over heaven and earth is the Son of God and Son of Man. We know Him as Jesus. In a world that has so many other authorities that want to claim us, we join in declaring that Christ is the King over all creation. A king and queen, that's not an image you're overly familiar with. Yes, we hear a bit about our British friends and their monarchy, and fans of historical novels and fantasy adventures get to read about kings and queens. But we don't live with that singular authority figure that live in historic kingdoms. Monarchs with the power of life and death over their subjects. So what does it mean for us to say that Christ is the King? Well, there are some familiar elements in this claim, as it does mean that Jesus himself is the ultimate authority and is the only one with true life and death power over creation. But this King is a very different kind of King from earthly ones. This King never worried much about protocol and status and the trappings of authority, no palaces or pomp and circumstance. His only throne was a cross. His only crown was one made of thorns. And instead of being surrounded by the wealthy and powerful and all the right people, this king was often known to hang out with sinners, shepherds, party goers. Certainly not the kind of people that protocol would allow around in England, you know? And he hung out with them simply because he loved them, as he loves all of those whom the world despises and rejects. This king celebrated with the common folks at their weddings and even made more wine when the host ran out to keep the party going. And this king allowed himself to be crucified for the sake of this rabble, because he loved them as he loved all of his creation. And even there, on that cross, he wound up breathing his last